Okay, we're going to try this pattern for Tangle It Pattern Club on Facebook and over at patterncollections.com. We're doing a daily pattern. This one is called Lichen or Lichen. I'm just going to give this a go. I've not done this particular one. I've done one similar. We've already done a grid pattern that's very much like this on that patterns grid pattern video. We're going to give this a go and see if we can make a pattern, a tile for the challenge. It appears that you start with pencil grid, so you get rid of the grid when you're done. So I'm going to just quickly do a quick non-square pencil grid. Doesn't really make any difference. Yeah, we're going to go like that. Something like that. Alright, because I'm going to erase it anyway, so it doesn't make any difference. Let me make sure I have my eraser next to me so that I have it ready to go. Alright. Eraser. Alright. So. And we're going to do this. It goes like that and like that. And then you skip one and you do that and that. And then you do that and that. And then you're doing a skipping pattern, so it's every other one. And then you skip and so it's this one and this one. And you skip that one, so it's this one and that one. Yeah? Like so. So half of that one. So it's more of an OG grid, I believe, rather than a, I don't know, kind of hard to figure it out. Ready then. So then in here we go this way and this way, and here we go this way, that way, and I think I'll put one going this way, same over here, and then this one goes this way, and that way, and I'm going to finish off these sides on this end, yeah, yeah, that way, and this way, and that way, and that way, and that way. Okay. Sorry, I made you wiggle. Let's get rid of the grid so it's not distracting me. Get rid of my border too. That's distracting me. I can always put it back in at the end if I want. Okay. So, within that, we do auras. One, two, three. One, two, three. I'm going to do three. Yeah? I think I'm going to do a circle in the middle. Okay. I think that's what I'm going to do. One, two, three. One, two, three. And do a circle. One, two, three. Ooh, that one had quite the gap to it. Well, whatever. One, two, three. Okay. and then this direction. 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. I feel like it needs, I don't know, it needs something. It's the grid pattern, and it's sort of organic. But it's going to need something. I'm not sure what yet. Maybe a little mucha. I haven't done mucha in a while. Maybe I'll put some mucha with this. I don't know why mucha came to mind all of a sudden, because it just doesn't seem like it's the type of tangle that mucha goes with, but, you know, it has come to mind for a reason. I always figure that as I'm drawing, if a particular pattern comes to mind for a reason, it's because the tile is speaking to me. Going 3 and 3, and I'm going to put a circle right there. And I think in those orbs, they're going to be colored in everything except for a little highlight, I think. That's what those want. Like that. Yeah. I think that's what those want. Have a little highlight somewhere in there. And color those in. Okay. Bigger than others, that's okay. I have not much to say today. That's okay too. I'm not really, this one's not really a lesson. This one's more of a just doing it on camera. We'll see what comes out. And if you guys learn something from it, great. And if not, that's okay. It wasn't really meant as a lesson anyway. This is this pattern, what is it called? Lichen, L-I-C-H-E-N. Apparently it was developed with some sort of fungus in mind. Yeah? I've never seen a fungus look like this before, but, you know. There are lots of places in the world I've never been and lots of things I've never seen, so it is entirely possible. There is a fungus that looks something like this. All right, that looks good, and it's saying that I have to do mucha with it, so we're gonna do some muchas attached like that. I think that's what I am, it's telling me to do. It's telling me to do mucha. Maybe my dear friend Mildred is watching over me today. She was the mucha maven. Mucha was her pattern. It spoke to her. It was her identity in the Zentangle community. And I miss her. I really do. So perhaps Mildred is speaking to me through this tangle. And that would be very cool. Mukha is a pattern where you don't lift your pen, you just do this really neat sort of a swirl thing. You can do them over and above each other, you can overlap. And I'll do an overlapping one here. That one really didn't come out the way I anticipated, but maybe if I do another one here, it will help ground that one. That's not so bad. Okay. Nice big loopy mukha. And one here, I think. It's telling me to go right there. Yep. That looks good. Now we'll shade that puppy. Where's my pencil? Alright. Oh, I want to shade that. I think I want to do this. Around each one of these. Sort of eyeball-like shapes. I don't know what they are. Very interesting. I think I want them to do that. Oops, too much pencil. Always remember you can take off pencil, it's unwanted. If I do them there, that will make these corners right here kind of dark because that's where they're all coming together, and that's, I think I like that. At the bottom of my mukhas, I like to have a little bit of shadow right there, and then just where they overlap on, if they're overlapping. A little bit, right? Give them some depth. Doesn't take much. Just takes a tiny little bit of pencil, just in the right spots. Just a little outside the lines here. Right there. Okay. Right there, right there. Right there. There at the bottom. This one overlaps that one. That one overlaps that one. Give a little bit of something, something. Alright, let's blend that. See what I got. This might not be the most exciting video ever, because I'm not teaching. So since I'm not teaching, I'm not talking. Oops. I think I want the insides of all of them, so I gotta go this way. I've missed one. Might be one to put music behind. I don't know. That looks pretty good. Got a little bit of pencil where I didn't want it on the outside of that. Fix that. Alright, I like it. Let's give that guy a signature. And I'm done. Others, that's okay. I have not much to say today. That's okay too. I'm not really, this one's not really a lesson. This one's more of a just doing it on camera. We'll see what comes out. And if you guys learn something from it, great. And if not, that's okay. It wasn't really meant as a lesson anyway. This is this pattern, what is it called? Lichen, L-I-C-H-E-N. Apparently it was developed with some sort of fungus in mind. Yeah? I've never seen a fungus look like this before, but, you know. There are lots of places in the world I've never been and lots of things I've never seen, so it is entirely possible. There is a fungus that looks something like this. Alright. That looks good. And it's saying that I have to do muko with it. So we're gonna do some mukos attached like that. I think that's what I am. It's telling me to do. It's telling me to do muka. Maybe maybe gray then. So then in here we go this way and this way. And here we go this way, that way. And I think I'll put one going this way. Same over here. And then this one goes this way and that way. And I'm going to finish off these sides on this end. Yeah? Yeah. That way, and this way, and that way, and that way, and that way. Okay. Sorry I made you wiggle. Let's get rid of the grid so it's not distracting me. Alright, I'm going to get rid of my border too. That's distracting me. I can always put it back in at the end if I want. Okay, so within that, we do auras. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. I'm gonna do 3. Yeah? I think I'm gonna do a circle in the middle. Okay. I think that's what I'm gonna do. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and just a circle. 1, 2, 3. Oop, that one had quite the gap to it. Well, whatever. The grid pattern, and it's sort of organic. It's going to need something. I'm not sure what yet. Maybe a little mucca. I haven't done mucca in a while. Maybe I'll put some mucca with this. I don't know why mucca came to mind all of a sudden, because it just doesn't seem like it's the type of tangle that mucca goes with, but, you know, it has come to mind for a reason. I always figure that as I'm drawing, if a particular pattern comes to mind for a reason, it's because the tile is speaking to me. Going 3 and 3, and I'm going to put a circle right there. And I think in those orbs, they're going to be colored in everything except for a little highlight. I think that's what those want. Like that. Yeah, I think that's what those want. Have a little highlight somewhere in there. And color those in. Okay, we're going to try this pattern for Tangle It Pattern Club on Facebook, and over at patterncollections.com. We're doing a daily pattern This one is called Lichen or Lichen. I'm just going to give this a go. I've not done this particular one. I've done one similar. We've already done a grid pattern that's very much like this on that patterns grid pattern video. But we're going to give this a go and see if we can make a pattern, a tile for the challenge. It appears that you start with pencil grid, so you get rid of the grid when you're done. So I'm going to just quickly do a quick non-square pencil grid. Doesn't really make any difference. Yeah, we're going to go like that. Something like that. Alright, because I'm going to erase it anyway, so it doesn't make any difference. Let me make sure I have my eraser next to me so that I have it ready to go. Alright. Eraser. Alright. So. And we're going to do this. It goes like that and like that. And then you skip one and you do that and that. And then you do that and that. And then you're doing a skipping pattern, so it's every other one. And then you skip, and so it's this one and this one. And you skip that one, so it's this one and that one. Yeah? Like so. So half of that one. So it's more of an OG grid, I believe, rather than a, I don't know, it's kind of hard to figure it out. My dear friend Mildred is watching over me today. She was the Mooka Maven. Mooka was her pattern. It spoke to her. It was her identity in the Zentangle community. And I miss her. I really do. So perhaps Mildred is speaking to me through this tangle. And that would be very cool. Mooka is a pattern where you don't lift your pen. You just do this really neat sort of a swirl thing. You can do them over and above each other. You can overlap. I'll do an overlapping one here. That one really didn't come out the way I anticipated, but maybe if I do another one here, it will help ground that one. That's not so bad. Okay. Nice big loopy Mooka. And one here, I think. It's telling me to go right there. Yep. That looks good. Now we'll shade that puppy. Where's my pencil? All right. Ah. Oh, I want to shade that. I think I want to do this. Around each one of these. Sort of eyeball-like shapes. I don't know what they are. Very interesting.